9 to 10 is Preacher, the Prophet, the Psychic, coming back at you again with another video. Woo! Everybody trying to get me to jump on this. People are trying to get me to get a ride and to get on this team bandwagon. I got all kind of people telling me, Magic Man, look how good that team bandwagon look. Boy, look how good he looked that they hitting those backhands, those winners, beating the Dow, whooping the Dow. People trying to get me to get on this team bandwagon. Now, people, check this out. I'm out here in Southern California, yo. And I need to get across. There's a county fair every year that I'm going to. And there's a, you can take out of the Nadal bandwagon because you got to cross a river and to get to the fair. And you want to make sure you have a good bandwagon, because down in the river there's alligators, crocodiles, and there's some great whites in that river too. Don't ask me how great whites got down in a river here in Southern California, but there's a great whites down there. So you want to make sure you own a good bandwagon. So every year, and it's during the French Open time too, I pay $100 to ride the Nadal bandwagon. Now the team bandwagon is only $10. Now, see what happened last year. A lot of people jumped on that team bandwagon, especially when team beat Nadal before the French Open in that tournament there. Whichever tournament he beat him in last year. I forgot. I don't know if it was a Barcelona, Madrid, Monte Carlo, whichever one it was. But when team beat Nadal there, a lot of people jumped on the team bandwagon. But see, they didn't do like I did. See, I read the Consumer Reports. And the Consumer Reports already has some complaints about that team bandwagon. And I also talked to some Firestone. I went to Firestone, and the Firestone expert told me don't trust those tires on the team bandwagon. They say Nadal's tires are good for like 100,000 miles. They say team tires, the tires on team's bandwagon is only good for like about 1,000 miles. So so I checked the Consumer Reports, and this Consumer Report, consumer organization made some complaints to the government about that team bandwagon. People last year, a lot of people died because they paid that $10, that cheap $10 for that cheap team bandwagon that can't go longer than a tournament or two without being inconsistent. That team bandwagon with those sorry ass tires on it, and they got to see the thing about it now. They got the team bandwagon looking really good, boy. You see how good team look today? So a lot of people, they jumping on the team bandwagon. They betting money. They already sent it now. They sending me comments saying team gonna beat Nadal in the French Open and all this other stuff, crazy nonsense. So everybody jumping on that team bandwagon. But let me get back to last year. See, they did that last year, people. Remember I told you, team beating Nadal last year, leading up to the French Open. A lot of people pay that $10 instead of paying that $100 to be on the Nadal bandwagon. That bandwagon that's been taking you across the river 16 times, 16 majors, 10 French Opens. But people wanted to go the cheap way, so they jumped on that team bandwagon. And you know what? The bandwagon, y'all know what happened. A lot of people lost their lives last year. There's a lot of lawsuits and wrongful death lawsuits against the team bandwagon company, because they was warned by the government that those tires on the team bandwagon, they don't last. That some days they look good, and some days they take you across the river, and some days they won't. And so what happened was, a lot of people got on that team bandwagon last year. And as we was going in the French Open, as we was going towards the county fair, that French Open, when he met Nadal, he got beat down. Because I told y'all, Firestone said, the Firestone experts, and Firestone, that you know Firestone is an expert. expert when it comes to tires. They said those teen tires, they look good, but they those are those old tires from the junkyard. Those old recycled tires. And the Magic Man, we know those tires don't last a long time. They can blow out. And so the tires blew out last year. They blew out. And the whole team bandwagon went across. It went down in the river where the alligators, the crocodiles, and the great white. Sorry, I don't need to finish this story. But now we're back here again. Team bandwagon again. Team beating the Dow again for the French Open. People getting on the team bandwagon. They don't want to pay that $100 to Nadal to have security. To get on a bandwagon that's taking you across the river many, many, many times. But they want to pay for that old cheap team bandwagon. That cheap team bandwagon. And you know what? The thing about that bandwagon right now, they got it looking really good. See, that's what the Consumer Report warned the government about that. And they warned consumers. They say that team bandwagon, on some days, it look as good as the Nadal bandwagon. But if you take a closer look, and if you watch it by the week, you'll see that the bandwagon, sometimes it'll take you across. Sometimes the tires last across the river. And sometimes, those inconsistent tires, they'll blow out before you can make it across the river. And next thing you know, you're down there with the alligators and the crocodiles. Man, I'm not jumping on that team bandwagon. You know what, people? He's a tennis friend, but he's a Las Vegas gambler, people. And he got a list of people not to bet on. You know who the number one person on his list? He always told me, Magic Man, there's some people you just don't bet on. I mean, you just let them, you don't bet money on them. It ain't saying they're not going to win a major. And you know what the number one guy on his list is? It's not team, it's Burdage. He said, Magic Man, never bet on Burdage. He got a list of about 8 people. He said, you don't bet on these kind of people. Not like, Dale Potro is not on the list. Now the Chilets, they don't have as many majors as Nadal and Federer, but they do have one. He said, don't bet on Burdage. Woo! Whoa, you talking about team. Man, I would put a penny on Burdage, but that's another story. But that team, guess what? He said he don't put money on team. He's got team on the list. Team ain't like number 2, but team is on that list. He said he won't bet money on team, though. Now, he ain't saying that team could win a French Open, but he said he ain't gonna put no money on it. He said, because he's seen the inconsistency. Okay, people, tennis preacher, I would not get on that bandwagon. Like I said, if team wins the French Open, okay, then I do a videos, a mini videos. If he wins the French Open, I won't do one video. Probably do 10 videos on it. Team has won the French Open. But until that time, I'm not holding my breath. Tennis preacher, tennis prophet, tennis psychic. Have a good one. Ha ha ha.